Did you wake up with swollen fingers and it was challenging to make a grip or just use your hands? Or maybe your hands starting to change colors and turn blue, leaving you puzzled? Are these minor symptoms or are they pointing to something bigger, like an autoimmune disease? I'm Dr. Diana Girnita, a rheumatologist with years of experience helping patients to uncover the mysteries of autoimmune diseases. Today, we are diving into a rare but often puzzling autoimmune disease called mixed connective tissue disease, or MCTD. Why do I call it puzzling autoimmune disease? Because it can look like lupus, scleroderma, myositis, and rheumatoid arthritis, but it is none of this. In this video, I will teach you the 10 signs of MCTD that you should not ignore. Puffy fingers. Let me share the story of one of my patients. Sarah was a 34-year-old teacher. One morning, she noticed that her fingers were swollen and stiff, and then she realized that for a few months now, she has been having difficulties to put her wedding ring in the morning because her fingers were too swollen. In the beginning, she thought that it was because of long hours of grading papers or because she ate something more salty, causing water retention. But then she realized that her fingers were persistently swollen and stiff every morning. Could that be a simple issue or something more? Actually, puffy fingers are often an early sign of MCTD, or mixed connective tissue disease. And it is caused by the fact that the tendons and the joints, they have subtle signs of inflammation and vascular changes. The fingers can become swollen and stiff primarily in the morning. And by the end of the day, they can improve. Now, many ladies notice that they have difficulties to put a ring on, or they have difficulties to use their hands to brush their teeth in the morning or grab a cup of coffee because their grip is affected. And for Sarah, this was the first warning sign, Raynaud's phenomenon. Then on colder days, especially in the snowy days, Sarah started to notice that her fingers are turning white and then blue, which can cause her a lot of tingling and numbness in the hands. She thought maybe this is because of poor circulation, but actually this is Raynaud's phenomenon, which is another common symptom of MCTD. Raynaud's phenomenon happens because of the spasm in your blood vessels, and in some cases can progress to even more severe forms where it can cause ulcers, which are very painful, and it can cause the tissue damage of your skin. But Sarah didn't realize in the beginning that this was the second clue. Over time, Sarah's puffy fingers became more painful and more swollen, and she started to develop what we call digital vasculopathy, which is actually a more complicated condition where the blood flow to the fingers is compromised, and that can lead to ulcerations of the skin. But she was not aware that this was actually another sign, and it was time for her to see a doctor. Further on, in a few months, more symptoms were coming to the surface. Skin involvement, or a butterfly rash. One day during the summer, Sarah noticed that a rash spreading across her cheeks and the nose was appearing. She blamed it on the stress and then burning from the sun. But it was actually a lupus-like rash, which is another important sign of MCTD. Now, patients with MCTD can also develop other skin changes like chilblains, panniculitis, or oral and genital ulcers. Chilblains presents as a painful rash on the fingers or on the toes that looks like a bluish discoloration of the skin. Panniculitis is actually an inflammation of the subcutaneous tissue on the abdomen, on the legs, on the breast, and it can be very painful. And the skin in that area is red, raised, and very painful, as I said. Fatigue and muscle pain. Let's go back to the Sarah story. She started then to experience more symptoms, like severe fatigue. Every day became a challenge. She was constantly exhausted, even when she had a good 9 to 10 hours of night sleep. She was constantly feeling tired and her muscles were aching. She felt like she ran the marathon each day, except that she didn't. Many times she would experience weakness, which can involve the upper part of her arms. She had days when it was so hard for her to get up on the stairs. It was so hard for her to use her arms to put something on a shelf, and every day she became weaker and weaker. Finally, she was at a turning point. She knew something wasn't right. In fact, severe fatigue and muscle pains are very common in patients with MCTD. Many patients, when they describe these symptoms, they are labeled with a diagnosis that we call fibromyalgia. However, the muscle pain can be a sign of MCTD, and many times it varies in intensity. It can be mild, like an ache, or it can be severe because of the inflammation in the muscles. And this process is called myositis. The symptoms can mimic polymyositis, which is another autoimmune disease. These can cause severe weakness when you use your hands. For example, you can have difficulties to mix in a bowl. And then, if it will affect the thighs muscles, this can cause difficulties to get out of the chair or get out of the car. And many times, patients will need to push themselves out of the chair, or they need to grab on something to climb stairs. Arthritis. But Sarah's symptoms did not stop to muscle weakness. And in about 6 months, she began to experience more stiffness and more swollen joints. And she had swelling in her hands, she had swelling in her feet and in her ankles. And it felt just like rheumatoid arthritis. Now, let me tell you, yes, in patients with MCTD, 60% of them will develop a type of inflammatory arthritis that mimics rheumatoid arthritis. And it may involve the hands, the feet in a symmetric pattern. But unlike rheumatoid arthritis, it tends to cause less damage, less deformities, and there are fewer joint erosions. What makes it even more confusing is that sometimes the rheumatoid factor and the anti-CCP antibodies can be positive in some patients, and that makes people to believe that they are dealing with rheumatoid arthritis. Shortness of breath. Then one day, Sarah noticed that she was unusually short of breath, and she has been experiencing chest pain when she was taking a deep breath. Her heart was signaling trouble. But little did she know that patients with MCTD, they can have heart issues like pericarditis, which is an inflammation of the lining of the heart, or myocarditis, which is inflammation of the heart muscle. In fact, 40% of patients with MCTD, they develop pericarditis, and a small percentage will develop myocarditis. Some patients can even develop arrhythmias, like atrioventricular blocks, or increased atherosclerosis, or even cardiac fibrosis because of this ongoing inflammation that are happening in their body. Lung involvement. Another sign that she discovered was that often she would battle a dry cough. Gradually, her cough was accompanied by shortness of breath. When she had an evaluation of her lungs, her doctor ordered a CT of the lungs, which actually showed that she had some mild changes of fibrosis, which is the thickening of the lungs. Was this a sign of MCTD? Unfortunately, yes. Her lungs were showing changes which were consistent with what we call interstitial lung disease or lung fibrosis, which again is another MCTD complication. But the lungs can be affected in many ways by MCTD, from pleural effusions, which is the fluid around the lungs, to lung clots, sometimes blood in the alveoli, interstitial lung disease, and pulmonary hypertension. And many of these complications will require a lung doctor to evaluate you further. But the journey of Sarah continues. I know you listened to many of her symptoms, but you should continue to stay with me, as more clues will get you to the right diagnosis sooner. Neurological symptoms. Now, Sarah remembers this particular afternoon. She started to experience a sharp, very severe facial pain on the right side of her face. With every move of her jaw, with every bite, she was in excruciating pain. First, She thought it might be because of a tooth issue. And then she remembered that she had her regular dental checkup 2 weeks ago, but it was no problem there. She called her doctor, who finally diagnosed her with trigeminal neuralgia. Can sharp facial pain be seen in patients with MCTD? Yes, trigeminal neuralgia, which can cause severe facial pain, this is a frequent neurological complaint of patients with MCTD. There are other symptoms like headaches, hearing loss, and very rarely other neurological signs like transverse myelitis or a demyelinating disease can also be seen in patients with MCTD. Sika symptoms, dry eyes and dry mouth. After that episode of horrendous facial pain went away, poor Sarah noticed that her eyes were very dry and her mouth felt like a desert. We call this dryness in the mouth and the eyes Sika syndrome. A Sika means dryness. While many people associate the dryness of the eyes and the dryness of the mouth with Sjogren's disease, about 30% of patients with MCTD experience these symptoms. The dryness of the eyes can cause irritation, a gritty feeling, a foreign sensation in the eyes, while the dryness in the mouth can cause a lot of dental issues, premature teeth loss, ulcerations in the mouth, and it can change the way that you taste the food, and it can also cause issue when you swallow dry foods. Gastrointestinal symptoms. Looking back, since she was a teenager, Sarah has been battling many issues with her digestion, from heartburns to abdominal pain to bloating and constipation. But she never thought that these symptoms were actually connected with more of her recent medical issues. She had no idea that actually 60 to 80% of patients with MCTD will experience digestive issues that can be very similar to those seen in patients with systemic sclerosis or scleroderma. For Sarah, the journey to a diagnosis wasn't easy because it took almost 4 years of puzzling symptoms and many visits to her primary care physician. But eventually, he listened to her and he thought maybe this is an autoimmune disease. So that's how she got a referral to rheumatology. When she came to me, I reviewed her chart carefully. I listened to her story unfolding over many years. And then again, I reviewed all the tests that she had in the last 4 years. And they were many tests, from lab work that showed a positive DNA to mild anemia, to low white blood cells, to an EKG that actually showed signs of pericarditis, and to a CT scan that showed me that she had signs of lung fibrosis. And I decided that it was worth to evaluate her further for an autoimmune disease. And my tests were even more comprehensive because I looked to make sure that she got the right diagnosis, because in this way, I could give her the best chance to treat her disease. Sarah had many of the diagnostic criteria for MCTD, and her laboratory test showed a positive DNA and a positive U1-RNP antibody, while all the other antibodies, double-stranded DNA, Smith, SSA, SSB, anticentromere, and SCL70 were all negative, which helped me to diagnose her confidently with mixed connective tissue disease. As you can see from Sarah's story, MCTD, it's a complex autoimmune disease, but recognizing these 10 signs early, puffy fingers, Raynaud's phenomenon, butterfly rash or skin changes, fatigue and muscle pain, joint pain, the shortness of breath, and also chest pain, and sometimes the dry cough, the facial pain, the dryness of the eyes and the mouth, and also the abdominal pain, constipation, can make a world of difference. If Sarah's story resonates with you, or if you notice any similar symptoms, don't wait. Reach out to a rheumatologist. At Rheumatologist on Call, we specialize in personalized care for autoimmune conditions, and we help patients like Sarah find the right answers and also take control of their health. And now you might wonder, what is life like after an MCTD diagnosis? For Sarah, it meant a personalized treatment plan, lifestyle adjustments, and a regular monitoring. Her medications, including hydroxychloroquine to manage the joint pain and inflammation, and some calcium channel blockers to prevent Raynaud's attacks. She changed her life, and she ate many more anti-inflammatory foods, which helped her to decrease the inflammation. She started to exercise regularly, which helped her joints, but also her mood. She promised herself to be very consistent in keeping her sleep schedule, and every night at 10 p.m., she was in bed with no phones and no TV around to distract her. And she started to write a gratitude journal. And every day, she wrote three things that made her grateful. With each day, Sarah felt better, she felt stronger, and in more control of her autoimmune symptoms. And for 4 years now, my dear patient Sarah, she has come to her appointments every 3 months, and we make sure that her autoimmune disease is under control. And now that you have learned about this 10 warning signs for MCTD, you should also learn about other signs and symptoms of other autoimmune diseases, because if you miss these signs, you will face consequences of being diagnosed late. So check out this video here.